celebrating 28 years, so far, of teaching Photoshop. Here's Dave Cross with another in his series of 28 Photoshop tips.
Hey, Dave Cross here with tip number 17 in our series of 28 Photoshop tips. This one, we're going to take a look at something I might call reverse cropping. This is a really interesting idea when you're trying to change the canvas size, but instead of doing it mathematically or by measurement, you just want to do it visually. So here's the image I'm working on. If I go to the canvas size command, it'll tell me the size, but if I was trying to increase the canvas, I'd have to either do some math here or click relative or something. And all I want to do is just add a little more canvas to one side. So I'm just going to zoom out a little bit, and all I do is tap letter C for my crop tool, and then simply just drag out, say I want to add this much canvas. And when you hit enter, the canvas is added for you, and now you could do whatever you wanted with this in terms of, you know, content-aware fill or whatever it might be, but the point is, it's so much faster to simply use the crop tool and drag out as much as you want rather than do the math. Let me show you one more example real quick. I'm going to undo that, go back to the crop tool, but this time before I start dragging, I hold down Option on the Mac, Alt for PC, and as I drag out, you see it's dragging from the center outwards, so I can add, in effect, a border all around the outside simply by dragging, not having to do any math. That's it. Pretty quick, but pretty useful tip. Use it all the time because it's just a really nice way to add more canvas doing a reverse crop. We'll see you next time for another quick Photoshop tip.